All I know back in the, you know, you never know. Elite might do it. Because I'm thinking, I think the trade, because if you really, if I, this is like a brainstorm. I thought about this a couple days ago. If you really think about it, it's because if 2K do something, they're going to do it. It's going, because one is going to have something that the other one didn't have and try and make it better and exploit that other company's weakness and put it in their stuff, put it on their game. That's how I'm looking at it. If you think about it, because Live long time ago used to have all the old teams. They used to have all the old school teams, and they used to have all the old school players. Then they took that out, you know, and now they got the, you know, now they add other stuff, like, you know, the FIFA. You know, that's one good thing, you know, the FIFA. And a lot of people, you know, they don't play the FIFA. The FIFA fun as heck.
Yeah, using all the national teams and everything. That's right. Fun.
They don't. A lot of people don't use the FIFA, and a lot of people don't pay attention to the, you know, some of the details that's on the FIFA. You know, I'm not gonna get into all that, but that's one feature that's never going to leave. They gonna keep the FIFA. That's not going nowhere. And the and then with, you know, with 2K, you know, I think that, you know, they keep, you know, they, because they used to have the, what was that, the 70 All Stars, the 80s, the 90s. They would have them, and then, you know, and, you know, now they bringing the Jordan, they bringing all the old school teams and stuff like that. You know, that's a good idea for them to do, like, you know, NBA moments. It doesn't have to be a specific just Jordan. They can do NBA moments and just think about, can you rewrite history and doing this? Relive the whole situation of that, you know. Karl Malone's miraculous performance in United Center, Game 5, NBA Finals, 98. Or,
yeah, and I even got a recent one, but it's you know, it's the Tracy McGrady, the 13 points in whatever, how many seconds
right,
it was.
Right.
That's another moment. Kobe's 81.
Yep.
You know, Kobe's game winner on the Suns.
Well,
there's
a
lot of moments they could do.
They got Kobe's 81 in Live, but you got to achieve it. You got to score 81 points.
Yeah.
They got it, but it's not like something that's like, you know. You know, and it's like when you do it, when you play it, a lot of people don't know this, when you play it, it's actually like the same real thing that he did in a real life game with the crowd. That's crazy.
Yeah.
They got it in the game in Staples. That's crazy. But it's crazy. But yeah, but you know, that'd be a good direction for 2K, I think. You know, if they stay on that route with it, you know, cuz the Jordan thing was brilliant to me. At first, I thought it was kind of like, y'all really, really trying to get as many customers as y'all can get. But it's like, why not do it? Jordan ain't been in the game. You know, Jordan ain't been in the game since 2000. No, I take that back. I'm sorry. Jordan has not been in the game since 2002. Because he was all in the other games because he was with the Wizards.
Yeah.
You know, I'm talking about just him just being in the game with him being in a Bulls jersey. The last time that he was in one, he was in Live 2000. And you had to unlock him. So,
it's been a pretty good discussion.
Right, you know. Let's see, what else? Now, how do you feel about the, let's see. Now, there's certain things in 2K that sometimes that really bothers me sometimes. And a lot of gamers out there, you know, because I played it. And it's like, the one thing is like, they have stuff like, now is it like a setting thing in the game where they always make all their shots and stuff? Cause I got my boy Shellac one time, and I mean, he just kept on draining shots. Can you like change the settings on your ranked stuff or something like that? I don't know.
Not in ranked, but it's all about momentum. And this is something I didn't get to talk about. I'll just talk about it right now. Is that the reason why so many contested shots go in 2K is because the game doesn't know that it's a contested shot. And the proof of this is the drills. Drills in my player, drills in association, such as the challenge shot drill or even a low post defense drill. After each possession, it'll actually say it in writing. It'll say excellent defense, average defense, poor defense, wide open. You know, it'll say things like that. And in those drills, sometimes you would contest the shot really good and the game would say wide open minus 50 points or whatever. So it's like,
what?
Wait a minute. It's like, wait a minute. I was all in his grill. I put my hand all up in there, perfect timing, and the game is telling me that he's wide open. So that's obviously why there's so many contested shots going in. It's because the game doesn't even realize the shot is being contested. Okay. So they have to figure out a way to make the contested shots better, make it, you know. If you contest a shot, it should play a role in the percentage. But if the game doesn't recognize that you're contesting a shot, it's one of the glitches. Like, a lot of times you'll pull up for a jump shot and the defender will actually be behind the shooter. He'll get, like, sucked behind the shooter. Or sometimes you contest and you jump. You, like, tippy-toe and jump. That's not a good contest. Or, you know, sometimes you'll jump the wrong way. And so they need to get those things sorted, and the percentages shooting would be a lot better. So that, you know, that's something that I didn't get to talk about because, you know, with 2K10, I didn't really focus that much on, you know, criticizing and everything. I just showed the gameplay and, you know, my league play and stuff like that. But that was one of the things I was going to talk about, but I just never got around to doing it. But that's why there's so many contested shots going in.
All right. And let's see what else. Now with the, let's see. Did they ever take that glitch out? The one when you go up and there's always a strip. Did they ever take that out?
They actually did fix that. In 2K9, anytime someone would drive, you just reach in and you can steal it. You can still do it every once in a while in 2K10, but they definitely fixed that, which was great. And so, but what they still need to do is reaching in. It's still a mess. You can reach in all you want in the backcourt. You know, you can just foul guys all game long, and there's no fouls. So they need to stop that, because it's annoying when you're playing a quick rank game or any kind of game mode and someone is reaching all the way up the court. And eventually they're going to get a steal, and there's no consequence for them doing that because there's no fouls.
Okay. Let's see. Now, I can tell you it's like one thing in 2K that I don't, that a lot of people will disagree with me and some people will agree with me, that I say live is kind of better. Now, a lot of y'all is going to say this. I'm going to say it's like, I can say the free throw stuff, okay? And I'm going to tell you why I say live free throws is a little bit better. Even though you can change it in 2K, but a lot of guys in 2K complain about this. I'm going to tell you.
The real free throw percentage, right?
Thank you. You hit it right on the head. Yep. If you play without the free throw percentages in 2K, once you get that free throw shot down, you can make that shot every time. And I say that's bull. If you play live, right, if you play live or whatever like that, it goes by their percentage. Y'all thinking, well, you just holding down a button and getting into a square. That's not, yeah, that's true. But if you play it a lot, it depends on the shooter. Some guys' bars are big. If they can't shoot, that bar is skinny as hell. And if you got somebody that's rattling your stick and they ratting that stuff real hard, it's real hard for you to make the free throw. That's realistic because it's going by percentage.
Yeah.
You know,
in 2K, the free throw ratings don't mean anything. It's all about the release. You know, you could have somebody with a, you know, 50 free throw rating like Dwight Howard or something like that. You get that release down, you're making all the free throws. What they need to do is, if you get a perfect release, then it should be exactly what the rating is. So if you, let's say somebody has like a 90 free throw rating, you get a perfect release at the free throw line, it should go in 90% of the time or whatever, you know, however they calculate that. If, you know, someone's a 70, you know, they have a 70 free throw rating, then when you get a perfect release, you should be missing some shots every once in a while. You shouldn't be making them, you know, every time. And then if it's someone like Dwight Howard, you know, you should miss the majority of your shots even though you're getting a perfect release. And then, of course, if you don't get a perfect release on the free throw, then those percentages should go down even more. So that's what they should do in 2K to just fix the whole free throw problem. Just do that.
Right. 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 Because that's what they got in the league for the free throws. They got the, you got to actually, it's not no bar no more. You actually got to make it. So y'all can actually understand so I'm going to tell you how it is. It's with the shooting as well. It's two graphs, okay? It's two graphs, if y'all didn't really understand it. If y'all already know what I'm talking about, then I'm going to tell y'all anyway. It's two graphs. You got the one graph where it's the ability of the player shot where they're good at on percentage, and then you got the one on the release and stuff meter, okay? Now, if you want a free throw line, if they can't shoot free throws, it's going to be very messed up for you to make that shot, for real. Because even if you try and hit it on the left or the right or whatever, which way that you do it, they have it so skinny and small, it's hard for you really to hit it.
Yep.
If they got, you know, or just say so for instance, you know, if it's big or whatever like that, they got a way where you can rattle it and change it. That's a good thing. So it's still difficult to do it. So it's like, so the free throws are just gonna be stationary on how to do it. It's like a cone, and you got to get it within that. It's really hard for me to describe. Now with the shooting, with it, now this is what's gonna trip y'all out. So y'all can, if y'all don't know this. The shooting is probably one of the best things on that game. I said it would be a glitch, but after I really read about it and I talked to Flash and I had a little conversation with him, he actually told me is that it's the jump shooting is based on defensive presence and defensive pressure. When y'all watch those videos, the ones that y'all saw that looked so bad and the reason why they was missing so many shots, it wasn't a button press. You got to actually get the stuff in the right stuff and know they shot and aim it. So it ain't no more predicated animations where the defense, where you can't control your defense. If they in your grill and you don't have a good shot, they're going to alter it or they're going to block it.
Makes
so,
sense.
You know,
the only thing is that the whole aiming with your shot, you know how there's like an aiming meter?
Right.
I don't really think that needs to be there. You know, like when I'm thinking about it, because when you're going up for a shot, I mean, it's like, all right, you want to get the timing down, but then you also have to aim the shot too. It's kind of like that might be a little bit too much, but I don't know. Maybe it might turn into something great. You never know.
It'll be great, and I'm gonna tell you why. When David Letterman said it's basically based on by luck, you have to do it. So that means your concentration level for you to make that shot, you have to do it. But it's also gonna be by percentage of that player. All I can tell you right now, Kobe's going to be ridiculous because his bar going to be huge.
Yeah, especially when he's in that mid-range territory. It's going to just be like,
right. It's going to be ridiculous. So I give you a prime example of how I could describe it. Remember in Madden, was it 06? No, wasn't 06. Was it 05? I think it was 05. Remember when they had the vision? With the quarterback vision, remember that?
Nope.
Okay, with the quarterback vision, and it wasn't where you had to move with the right thumbstick and move the quarterback's vision to get it on the receiver.
Are you talking about like how Backbreaker has that kind of camera angle?
No. It was in Madden. They had the vision, the cone vision, and it wasn't like the old Madden where you just press the button. You couldn't pass the ball unless you got the vision on the receiver.
Ooh, okay, I see what you're saying.
Right.
So you had to you had to highlight him when you wanted, and then pass it. So like, if you see him,
and it had to be in the proximity or the accuracy or whatever wouldn't be right. A lot of players didn't like that. They didn't. I liked it. And it was only two glitchy quarterbacks, and it was based on awareness. It was only two glitchy quarterbacks. Actually, it was three. Tom Brady, Peyton Manning, their awareness was 99, so the cone covered the whole field, so you didn't have to move their head or nothing. You could just throw the ball whenever you wanted. That was bogus. But any other quarterback, you had to move the cone to the receiver and get in that vicinity for the thing. It was just like a real quarterback looking off, where you can look off, you know, and stuff all like right. that. So, that's how that was with that. But that's how basically the elite is with that. So, you know, and you have to look at it like that. So, and you know, and that's how I look at it. But the shooter is going to be very, very good, and that's one thing that I do like about it. So, you know, the shooter is going to be there, and a lot of players is not going to like that. So, yeah.
So we'll see what the response is for that. But
right,
we're definitely going to have to do this again when the games finally come out. We can talk about, you know, because you're going to be the expert on live. You're going to be playing live for sure. I'm going to be playing 2K for sure. So then we can kind of get together and see, you know, what's going on with both games and how they're turning out. So right. We're definitely going to do this one again. So it was great. It was a great conversation. We got into a lot of insight. And also just stay tuned and check out his channel.
Yeah, check out my channel, y'all. If y'all need to know anything about it, just come see me. Just come check me out, you know. Y'all seeing Smoove. After y'all see this, like I say, check it out. Anything elite. And I got games up. Adidas Live Run games with the squad or whatever like that. Y'all can check it out and see what we do, you know. So I hope y'all enjoyed it. So, all right, Chris. Nice talking with you, bruh.
We're signing
out. All right, man. All right, man. Peace.